is Smita and you're watching Rendezvous with Smita Kumar at MediCircle. Today we have the co-founders of Herbia with us, who have recreated the age-old culture of infusion teas to suit our modern lifestyle. Indraneel Chitre, partner Chitre Group and founder Herbia. He co-founded Herbia to make Ayurveda more accessible. Indraneel is a fourth generation partner at the Chitre Group. Dr. Chinmay Bhosle, a criminal lawyer with gold medal and doctorate in law, he is known for his legal acumen to guide business into the future. So hi, Indraneel and Dr. Chinmay, welcome to MediCircle.
Thank you, Smita. Glad to be here.
So tell us more about Herbia.
Sure. So, the credit towards conceptualizing the idea of Herbie goes to Chinmay, because Chinmay was able to introduce me to a common friend of ours who is basically an Ayurvedic doctor. What we were able to determine was a problem statement where he was trying to make Ayurvedic products and try to make them more consumer friendly. So that is the time we figured out that, can we explore the option of making herbal infusions, which are something that can be had just like how you have green tea or herbal tea, but it is caffeine free, and that can be packaged in a manner which is highly consumer friendly, available beyond the medicinal aspect of Ayurveda, yet delivering the value of all the herbs and the ingredients that they actually constitute the product, and deliver those functions. So in that process, we were able to form the brand called Herbie, and the name, as it suggests, is that, it's a mixture of herbs, and that blended into different types of format is what we want to try and achieve with Herbie.
Okay. So with Herbia, your goal is to make Ayurveda more accessible. Do you think Ayurveda would be amongst the future trends of healthcare?
Yes, totally. So the way the world is changing right now, and the way high emphasis on the sustainability aspect is being relied upon by all the countries in the world. So be it the way the climate change is affecting, be it the way the industrialization is affecting, all of these aspects, there is a lot of thought given into making all of these processes sustainable. And similarly, all of these can become sustainable if the people who are running it also start living a sustainable lifestyle. So in that process, that is where Ayurveda as a principle comes into the picture, because Ayurveda thrives on the concept of sustainability, and something which is about more of a lifestyle consumption of product in moderation, rather than more of a reactive medicinal concept that we are used to with the modern medicine. So can Ayurveda come into the mainstream? I am pretty sure it can be done, and that is what we want to try and achieve with the startup, and that is where we have to try and bring in the age-old wisdom of Ayurveda, the recipes that have been there, the science behind it, and try and package it into a format which is more relevant to the modern consumer that we have around us. And what we want to try and achieve here is not just appeal to the Indian consumer, but appeal on a global level, where we can show that sustainable aspect of consumption of Ayurvedic-based products that can help enhance your lifestyle.
So this one is for you, Dr. Chinmay. What was the reason, yes, as a practicing criminal lawyer, for you to get into the startup space? And have you been involved in startups and investments too?
Being a day job of being a criminal lawyer, it is difficult to give some time to anything beyond that. But I've always have had the knack to try and contribute to businesses as well, because that's what I primarily do as a lawyer as well. So in that space, I have been an active investor with quite a few companies which have done fairly well in the past. That has been my liking. And at the family end as well, we do manage educational institutes, and that also gives me some headspace around managing institutes and business houses per se. So that, with my legal acumen, I definitely do like to have my head around the business angle as well. But thanks to my day job, I can't do it on a regular basis, but I do whatever I can. And as an investor as well, wherever possible, I do pitch in and make my investments.
Okay. So Indraneel, you are the fourth generation partner at the Chitre Group. How does it feel?
It's a great thing, to be honest, because if you look at the statistics of family businesses, just 2% of the family businesses that actually survive into the fourth generation. So, you know, I come into that unique bracket of 2% 2% people in the world where we have been able to get a great platform of having three generations behind us who have run the business successfully. Of course, along with that, there's also a great responsibility and a great legacy that we have to carry. So sometimes it can also be a pressure where we need to be much more deliberate in our actions of how they reflect onto the family business as well. So how do we balance that legacy that comes along with it while still being relevant as a family business and appeal to the next generation of consumers is the paradox that we are always trying to address. And I'm enjoying the role of being in that zone where, we have been able to do a lot of things right, even after taking responsibility. So I'm quite happy. And it's a unique factor to be in.
Indraneet, you are an investor and now an entrepreneur. How has the journey been? And what metrics are you tracking when considering an investment?
So, as I said, a lot business, a lot of emphasis lies on the aspect of sustainability. So the business also needs to have today's startups are growing in an exponential rate where very often they are not looking at how high their burn rate is or how unique their model of selling is or how they are going to actually break even and start making profit out of it. So what I try and focus on as an investor or as a entrepreneur myself is that how can we actually be creating products or services which are something that are sustainable, that definitely create value for the consumer as well as the supplier and the entire ecosystem around the startup, and something that can grow for a longer trajectory rather than just being short-sighted and playing the valuation. So that is what I try and look after, and that is how most of my investments have been planned around. And so also is my investment into Herbie, where I have taken up a responsibility of running it as well further.
That's great to know. So I think with your family business experience, you might, because see, again, there you're also dealing with consumers. So I think the value what you are generating through the products, through the services, that might be carried into any other startup, because at the end user is really, really important. The consumer is really important, and whether you are able to deliver in a proper way or not, it holds the most important place in any startup ecosystem. So thank you.
Very true, because if you're valuing the customer, then you are always going to be in demand.
Yes. And I think the experience of this would be really, really helpful in your new startup. And all the best for all your future endeavors. Thank you so much, Indraneet and Dr. Chinmay, for joining us on MediCircle. And
thanks a lot.
All the best for your.
I hope.
Thank you.
We have managed to make Ayurveda even better on the palate and not just on the stomach. So
yes,
let's hope you all like it and you do.
Because consumers really, really, because see, there is a lot of need, but we don't have those kinds of platforms and products. A lot of people actually look up to Ayurveda because that is one of the ancient sciences. And people during Corona, many of them have switched to Ramdev Baba's exercises and yoga, and has proved that it has actually reduced their anxieties, their medical conditions had improved. So there is a trust factor which is really working in your case. It would be like positively taken in your case. And at this time, pitching something would be really, really, really beneficial. And if there is a good product and a platform which you guys are offering, and if it is marketable at the same time and it is going to help the patients out there, it would definitely, change the way we look at Ayurveda, which is still, in the back, and it must be on the mainstream healthcare, because in any ways we generally go to an allopathic doctor, and that is the way. And also in India, like, we consider wellness and sick in a very different way. Unless and until we are too much sick, we generally don't visit a doctor. So I think
absolutely, essentially, as you rightly said, Ayurveda is taken in a very, very negative way in our country. You'll approach it only as a medicine. And that's why our earnest effort with Herbie has been that with our names as well, if you see, so if you have a SKU which is giving a tea which stabilizes blood sugar levels or helps blood sugar levels, instead of calling it, say, obesity tea, for example, others might call it, we have called it agility. So we want to give that positivity out of our product as well, because we want to show that Ayurveda is all about positivity and trying to curb the negativity to enter into your lifestyle or your life in the first place. So it's not a cure, it's a lifestyle which is going to help you remain free of all these ailments. So as you rightly said, let's hope that we bring Ayurveda in that positive space and everyone appreciates that.
Yes.
Correct. So if I was to add, so coming in from my engineering background, the thing is that, you know, there is always a basic question about maintenance, which applies to machines, but that also applies to humans as well, where, you know, there is a breakdown maintenance and there is a, you know, preventive maintenance. So very often the modern medicine is something that is breakdown, where after there is an effect, we try and take an action upon it, which is mostly reactive. Ayurveda, on the other hand, is more about, you know, a preventive maintenance, where we do activities on a sustained basis all the time, so that we ensure that the failure is actually not there.
So I think we must look on to this preventative factor rather than whenever the actual damage has been done and then approaching a medical practitioner or an allopathic medicine.
And I think that is where more and more preferences will be there for all the people around in the world, because they are understanding the importance of, you know, keeping themselves healthy. And this pandemic has actually highlighted a lot of people towards being healthy as a focus.
Thanks to Corona for that.
Yes.
So I think the way people used to take health, I think more and more people are getting more conscious about their health. They want to live healthy. They want to be healthy. And whatever means, I mean, it be it allopathic, Ayurveda, yoga, meditation, whatever, they are all trying it. So that is why I said it is really a good time for you to launch this kind of a product and a service which people can actually avail on an easy basis. So again, thank you so much, Indraneel and Dr. Chinmay, for joining us. Have a good day.
Thank you, Smita.